whether you're looking for nature tourism, whether you're looking for adventure tourism, whether you're looking for cultural tourism, food, cuisine, you know, and just good people, good happy people. We have it all in Cross River.
More than 600 years after European explorers ventured past these mangrove creeks and discovered a rich civilization and some of the most breathtaking scenery in West Africa, the ancient city of Calabar and the surrounding state of Cross River have continued to beguile travelers from around the world.
From time immemorial, we have been traders, explorers, and all that. And the first set of Europeans made contact with us right here.
From the Obudu Mountains in the north to the Atlantic Ocean in the south, Cross River State encloses a rich bazaar of stunning sunsets, high peaks, multi-streamed waterfalls, untamed rainforests, and rare wildlife, as well as an ancient history and some of the most developed tourist resorts in West Africa.
I have to say, there's so much potential here, and it's such a vibrant state. There's so much to see and do.
Today, with the Calabar Carnival breaking international records as Africa's biggest street party, Cross Riverians are proud to welcome people from all over the world to the greatest original festival on the continent.
It's no longer a Cross Riverian thing. It's a national thing. It's an African thing. We have people come from the Cameroons, Burkina Faso, and then we have international visitors as well. We get people coming from the UK, from Canada. We have some people from Russia.
Cross River State's modern resorts have developed an even bigger reputation, delivering world-class services, not just to tourists, but to businesses as well.
You cannot visit Cross River State and say you've received the entire experience if you didn't visit the Budu Ranch or the Marina Resort, where we have our strong strength and the icons of our roots, tourism and heritage.
This is Africa's longest cable car, set in the Obudu mountain range in the far north of Cross River State. The cable cars take visitors up to the Obudu mountain resort at the top and back down again. On a clear day, you can see all 22 spine-tingling hairpin bends and dozens of magnificent grazing ranges.
Uniqueness of the location provides unparalleled vistas. Those are world-class vistas. You are looking down from the roof, you're looking down on the clouds and down on the rest of the world. And it is particularly beautiful and unique here.
We have humongous water park. We have the grotto with the natural spring waters. We also have a nature reserve where we have a canopy walkway. This is where we have a bird sanctuary. We have all sorts of vegetation in there. It's really a forest that you can spend your afternoon.
The resort hotel itself, complete with modern chalets, is perched more than 2,000 meters above sea level, literally up in the clouds.
Accommodation is of three types. The first phase where we have the standard rooms, and then we have the second phase where we have the African huts, African bungalows. We also have the mountain villas, which are out of this world.
Between June and October, the resort is submerged in a spectacular fog with temperatures of between 4 and 10 degrees Celsius, as cold as any autumnal day in Europe. For the rest of the year, it's bright and sunny with temperatures between 26 and 32 degrees Celsius.
The climate here is, technically it's temperate, but it is very cool and very acceptable and almost European. People liken us to Scotland, for example. So that's unique in Nigeria and in West Africa.
The trip up there is a fabulous trip. You know, the scenery, the topography, the geography. And then once you get up there, of course, you're not far from the other site where the other drills are as well. So I think it's got, you know, tremendous tourism potential.
Cross River State is rich in wildlife, with nature reserves housing several species of primates, birds, and about 1,000 varieties of butterflies.
There's a lot of emphasis on our nature reserves and, of course, our green tourism. And that really is fundamental and key for us.
In the last 3 years in particular, Cross River has become the leading conservation state in Nigeria and West Africa. This is Drill Ranch, an internationally recognized center for the protection of endangered primates, particularly drill monkeys.
There's more drills in this group than exist in captivity in the rest of the world, and here in Cross River State, Nigeria, and I'm proud of that.
We now have over 350 drills in four generations living in seven family groups. And the one that you see here, the unlucky group, lives in Calabar at this small facility. And five other breeding groups live up in the forest at Afi Mountain, which is in Boki local government of Cross River State.
They have a unique social system of mingling amongst each other. And this also exposes them to danger in the wild due to poaching.
With support from the Cross River State government, such groundbreaking conservation efforts have created new possibilities for endangered species like the drills and for the growth of ecotourism.
This is the first settlement like in a bush area where you can see rainforest species. And we have six cabins and we can accommodate up to 15 people.
From this cabin, you can see animals in their natural environment, and it gives you the feeling of being around the animals, very sleeping close to the animals.
I loved it here. I mean, I've learned a lot about animals, but I always loved animals, but I come from a city, so all my interaction with animals was cats and dogs mainly.
Having program like this here is so important to the environment, so important to protect a species that's endangered.
It's the largest forest remaining in Nigeria and one of the 10 top hotspots in the world for biodiversity.
Dating back to the Jurassic period, this 72,000 square kilometer area of primary rainforest supports a huge quantity of life and contains about 86 species of trees per acre. Many of them are found nowhere else in the world. For decades, as a result of illegal logging, much of the rainforest was seriously depleted. Today, thanks to an international effort supported by Cross Riverians, over 90% of the forests are protected. It's turned this emerald wilderness into a hot tourist attraction, complete with the longest canopy walkway in West Africa.
I think it's an amazing state with an amazing product, tourism product to offer. It's beautiful, it's lush, it's green, it's got rivers, waterfalls.
Look at our sites. Look at the Agbokim waterfalls. Look at Afi Mountains. Look at Obudu. We are close to heaven. When you come in here, you don't feel you're in Nigeria.
About an hour's drive from these majestic waterfalls lies one of the most mysterious memorials to a sophisticated civilization that thrived in Cross River State more than 2,000 years ago. These ancient monoliths are an anthropologist's dream, a force in shaping the world here. With any number of hidden geometric meanings carved on them, they suggest the existence of a golden age of grandeur and education.
The monoliths we have here is over 2,000 years old. The Calabar terracotta today becomes one of the second oldest, you know, culture in Nigeria.
The transatlantic slave trade also thrived in these parts, especially among the tribal kingdoms that dominated the creeks and waterways surrounding Calabar. Between the 17th and 19th centuries, about 30% of the estimated 12.5 million slaves taken from Africa are thought to have passed through the Calabar area. Many local Calabar chiefs made massive profits as slave traders. The likes of King Eo Honesty, who built this mansion in Creek Town just outside Calabar some 300 years ago, became very rich and powerful. The Cross River State government has built this slavery museum at the city's Marina Resort to commemorate and immortalize Calabar's unique place in the transatlantic slave trade.
This one was used as a 16th century warehouse where goods and humans were being stored. And of course, that is why the Slave History Museum has been sited here.
The Slavery Museum also aims to attract thousands of tourists, especially African American and Caribbean peoples, who are returning to see where their ancestors came from.
Being here and being the first country I've been to in Africa has been very enlightening to me. And seeing Creektown and the Slave Museum and all of that, knowing about the port, has been, you know, really let me know where I've come from.
Beyond the Slavery Museum, the government has built a resort at the marina, complete with hotels, bars, and boat rides. From here, you can also hire a speedboat out to one of the many island beaches in the Atlantic Ocean, just 30 minutes away.
The marine, the aquaculture is quite captivating, you know, and also the serenity of the city.
It's marvelous, yeah, it's exciting. It's really a place to be.
Calabar is best. It is a great place to be.
Along this Marina Road was English dress shops, Portuguese, Dutch. In fact, Marina Resort saved as the first harbor.
With the end of slavery in the 19th century, came a wave of European missionaries. The most venerated of these is Mary Slessor, a Scottish woman from Dundee, who stopped the killing of twins in Old Calabar and used the gospel to touch many lives. Her grave remains a shrine and major tourist attraction to many Christians and visitors alike.
We have in Calabar a monument, a cenotaph of early missionaries who were here to spread education and the word of God. And can you imagine the prospect of our being able to link up with families of these early missionaries, about 100 or so of them, who are resting finally in the beds of Calabar.
By the early 20th century, the British had invaded and colonized Calabar. They made it Nigeria's first capital and turned it into an important trading port. Nothing stands as a greater testament to British imperial rule here than the old residency building, a prominent historical landmark in Calabar.
Old residency building, I tell you, remains one of the finest examples of colonial architecture in Nigeria. Then in 1986, it was restored and opened to the public as a National Museum of Calabar history and its environment.
Calabar also offers a rich variety of places that provide relaxation and recreational facilities. Places like the Zoo Garden Park in the center of town and the exclusive Aqua Vista Resort, tucked away in the creeks and swamps around Calabar and specializing in freshly caught seafood. Cross River State, as a whole, has one of the best culinary reputations in Nigeria.
In Cross River State, the only problem you may have with food is being able to choose from the amount you have, because we have so much to offer you, you may get confused.
By far the most upmarket of the resorts around Calabar is the Tinapa Business Resort, complete with its own world-class shopping center, water park, hotel, and Hollywood. And with the Atlantic Ocean only an hour away, the government and a host of private investors believe Tinapa will become a world-class business and entertainment resort, eventually transforming Calabar into a global tourist and trading hub.
It's very relaxing. It's great to come back home. And it's nice to see this kind of setup in Calabar. And my kids find it very, very enjoyable.
One of Tinapa's frequent visitors is the wife of the governor of Cross River State, Mrs. Obioma Liel Imoke.
The message we're trying to send to people is that you don't have to spend so much money just to go anywhere and have fun. Here you get everything, fun, business, trading, whatever you want to get. So my advice to them is look inward, look within first before looking out. There's nothing that they have out there that we don't have in here.
Recently, Tinapa announced the opening of T-Mart, the largest retail shop in Nigeria. The general manager, Tanya Williams, explained the company's decision to come to Tinapa.
The whole shopping complex is world class. It resembles a shopping complex anywhere you might see in the world. And you pretty much can come here, with it being a trade-free zone, that makes it within itself one of the best values, because you can import anything from anywhere in the world and sell it here.
Some of the biggest names in international entertainment, such as Hugh Masekela, have become regular performers here at Tinapa and around Calabar, especially in December when the city hosts a Christmas festival that lasts an incredible 32 days.
It's a very fascinating place for me, and I believe I'll be coming here a great deal, especially because of the state government's interest in the arts. And its support of the arts, because I don't know many countries in Africa that have a state like Calabar that is so keen and willing to support the arts.
We've had several other guys, we've had Naji, we've had Akon, Neo, we've had all sorts of artists coming, Donnie McLaughlin, Kirk Franklin. And to add to that, we also have, I would say, one of the best TV movie production facilities in West Africa, which has just recently been commissioned, and we're expecting a lot of movies to come in here.
We have grown to really playing big parts in movies, and we have the places here. I remember the film that is coming up soon, Streets of Calabar. It's all shot here. It's all shot in Cross River State.
From Africa to Asia, Europe to the Americas. In recent years, Cross Riverians have walked proudly amongst tourists and businessmen from all over the world, putting themselves on the front line of African tourism, daring to lead, but never ceasing to serve. Today, as West Africa's fastest growing tourist destination and Nigeria's safest state, Cross Riverians have brought Nigeria to the threshold of a new age.
We do have a location that can compete and compare with any other location within the West African sub-region. But in addition to that, tourism is affordable, the state is secure, extremely safe, people are most hospitable, and at the end of the day, I think there's no better experience in this part of the world than the Cross River experience.